Hey everybody, and welcome again to the Masterclass. This video we're going to talk about jump shots again. This is the second part of the video, so if you not watched part 1, watch it back so you start with a more solid and better basics about jump shots. We're going to walk through a couple things in this video. One of them is guidelines about making jump shots, and the other one will be about practice and some routines for making these jump shots. I'll be creating later a separate video regarding advanced jump shots, since it's so a lot to cover that it needs a separate video on itself, making these rather difficult jump shots and advanced techniques. Okay, got the cue ball in front of me, and as last time you probably noticed we discussed, making jump shots is required to use the butt angle. So the cue moves up and down, and when you do that, the maximum angle you can get on is 90 degrees. The lowest you can get is 0 degrees, so it's between 0 and 90 degrees to make a butt angle. Now if you lift that butt angle up onto 90 degrees, you get almost a vertical shot in the table. And that kind of shot gives the highest jump shot. We're gonna put the cue a little bit down, so a little bit less butt angle. And you will see that the shot will go a lot further on the table. The height may be less, but the shot itself is a lot further, almost at the end of the table. And that happens when you make a lower butt angle. So a high butt angle makes also high shots, and a lower butt angle will get you further. And of course you have to find, you know, that certain distance you need, which is of course different with every shot you take. Okay, in front of me I got a free view position, and I'm shooting the ball over the yellow ball. A lot of people think actually that that white line is a center, but it's not. It's a down part of the cue ball. And if that goes over the object ball, the ball will jump over it. So the white line is the line you will get eventually, and that's your real travel line of your jump shot. Okay, let's talk a little bit about guidelines. Got here the butt angle at 90 degrees. Going to raise the power a little bit more and more until I go to the 5 bars of power, and then I lock it. This is the power you need actually to actually make a proper jump shot. If you don't have enough power, you can never jump over the ball. And 5 is required to actually jump over the ball. This was your minimum need to actually do any jump shot. As you can see guys, I lock the power, so I make sure that I always hit with the consistent shot power. If I don't do it, there's a big chance I don't put the right power on, which means I'm gonna mess my jump shot up. Now since we know with 5 bars, the angle will actually become alive and it reaches a certain height to actually make the jump shot, I'm gonna put it on 7 bars here and also put it under a 90 degree butt angle to just give you guys a guideline for that, to use this in practice or during gameplay, because most of you guys will probably play sometimes without aiming 8 at all, so you don't see the line. And that's nice to have a guideline then, you know, 7 power, 90 degree angles, this works. And you have to make that for yourself as well. Guidelines to actually make things work. How much power do we need? What angle needs? I get this type of shot. Now, this is a nice start point to actually cover quite a lot of jump shots because of the reach it has. Okay guys, coming to the end of the video. Got here the practice table in front of me. I would say go to practice mode in Pool Nation FX. Break off. Use the M key to move the ball around and start practicing these jump shots. If you're good enough, at some point you can do it without aim off. I know I didn't do a lot jump shots in the video. There wasn't a point of it. It was to explain people how it really worked and the details of it. And then the next jump shot video, we're going to talk about advanced jump shots and a lot more other stuff, which you guys probably find interesting. So see you next time.